everybody. It's Michelle Patterson here with Angel Souls, and this is our daily card reading for December 12th, 2021. AngelSouls444.com if you'd like a personal reading with me, and that's Angelic and Akashic. I don't have an Akashic Records reading option on there. Just put it in your submission form that that's what you would like. And also extra content, including Archangel meditation challenges. I highly recommend, you know, doing the Gabriel or the Metatron one this time of year, or any of them that you haven't done yet. And that is over at gumroad.com/angelsouls. Let's see. What do we have here? Okay. First quarter moon in Taurus. Release control. Again, there's that ego thing that's coming in here and trying to push and trying to get things to look right, or to quote unquote do life right. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, no. This is a time. This is your real, like, spiritual test time. I usually don't put it that way, but I don't know how else to put it, okay? It is saying, okay, you've learned all these things. You have done all this, hopefully, self-development, self-improvement. Now you got to put it into action. And what is that going to look like for you? Now, the release control part is definitely talking about stop trying to think of it as like, okay, it can only be this way. Right? Again, that's why I have a problem with some fortune telling type readings, because that's not how energy works. That's one person's interpretation of your path. Okay. You could open it up really wide and can have like a co-creative, you know, part in creating what's to come, as opposed to it's just like this. And maybe you get into a space of fear, or it's just like this. And you think that's the only option, right? And you forget that, you know, that's influencing your future if you're afraid of it. Does that make sense? I don't know if I'm saying that right, but the whole point here is take your power back. Oh yes, take your power back. You take your power back by not being so fearful and not being controlling and working with the universe. It's kind of counterintuitive, but it's kind of standing back and saying, I'm not going to push in this direction. I'm going to see what's happening right here in my own field. And what is right for my soul's contract? What is the next thing for me to experience? A lot of us don't seem to understand that. I've had clients come and they want to get a reading about their adult children. You know, tell me what's going to happen in their lives. Ooh, that is interfering with someone's energy in a big way. We don't do that. Okay. And, you know, there have been certain circumstances where, you know, how that energy affects that person. We could talk about that. But as far as like trying to dive into somebody else's life and control it, there's a message out there for some of you. You need to back up. Okay. Now that doesn't mean don't step in and help people who need help. But if you think you know best about everybody, well, that's something to sit back and evaluate for yourself. What is your need to control others? Okay. Or are you somebody who's watching this and you are used to having a lot of control? Maybe you're somebody who's in a high position and you're used to people falling at your feet. And now you're having to look at that, because we are shifting in a big, big way. We are going to see the mighty shall fall. I just heard that. The mighty shall fall. Yeah. So we're talking about being disgraced. We're talking about things being revealed. So if you are somebody who's always expecting people to say yes to you, and you're just used to getting whatever the heck you want, whenever, that's going to change, and you need to evaluate that. And I would highly recommend you change your ways, make amends, you know, do that sort of thing. But this really is saying, okay, universe, I'm going to work with you. I'm not going to push against you. All right. So we're going to leave it there. I'm sending you all so much love, and take care.